Members of the Acholi Parliamentary Group have asked the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, to clear them to travel abroad to find out what exactly is happening to the Speaker of Parliament, Right Honourable Jacob Olanya, whose whereabouts have been unknown for the last 2 months. The group says it's anxious to establish exactly how their caucus member is doing.
Ugandans are wondering where the Speaker of the Parliament of Uganda is. And Ugandans are thinking that Acholi sub-region should be the one to ask many questions about that.
While addressing a press conference at Parliament today, leaders of the Acholi Parliamentary Group expressed disappointment over the continued absence of the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya. They reveal that they have not had a chance to hear from him for a long time, despite the fact that he is also a caucus member.
I want to make it very clear that when Jacob was elected, he became the Speaker of Uganda. The fact that he comes from our region does not leave the responsibility into our hands only. But I also have to make it very clear that as a truly parliamentary group, we will now go to the Speaker, the Deputy Speaker. We want to be given opportunity to visit the Speaker where he is and report to Ugandans. Because people have been complaining, people are wondering, there's no single evidence to give people what exactly is happening.
Olanya has been missing in Parliament for a period close to 2 months, and Acholi caucus members want the Deputy Speaker, Anita Among, to clear them to visit Olanya, who is said to be abroad for treatment.
We are running out of person. We need him. We know how his competency. We know how he can develop things. We know how he is really so passionate about the country and the activities. Just like our chairperson have said, we are just one day in the office. We are going to take up this matter. We want to go and see him. We want to go and visit him.
Yesterday, the Acholi Parliamentary Group elected its leadership chaired by Anthony Akol, the Kilak North County Member of Parliament. Akol has called for unity and outlined plans to deliver the sub-region out of poverty. According to the Uganda Bureau of Statistics, Acholi region is the poorest, with 68% of people living below the poverty line.
If you get 100 people in the Acholi sub-region, 68 people are poor people. Look at that situation, it's very worst. I mean, it's the worst in the country. If we are now surpassing Karamoja, you must know we are in problem. Because during Obote's region, the regime, he said, we cannot wait for Karamoja to develop. Now, look at what has happened now.
We want to join hand. We want to work in partnership with different stakeholders, whether being the NGO, civil society, the corporate body, companies, and as well as with the government of Uganda to make sure we lobby, we get more resources, we get more supports, that we can be able to utilize it effectively and efficiently to reduce the rate of the poverty level in our land.
MPs are concerned that the numerous government interventions to eradicate poverty in Acholi, including NUSAF 1, 2 and 3, together with PRDP, have turned out to be white elephants with no tangible impact on ground. They demand for a review of the projects.
We are going to do the analysis of what exactly happened. That is why we have created the secretariat to do for us the research. And find out of all these programs that government has done to Northern Uganda, why has it not benefited the people? Is the money just pumping the ground and coming back to Kampala? What is it? What is it exactly that after all this intervention, there is nothing changing in the people?
The members of parliament now expect much from the government, since the sub-region voted overwhelmingly for the NRM party in the January 14th elections. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.